welcome to Sardis. Welcome home. Welcome to all our guests and folks that have come back to see us on this wonderful homecoming Sunday here as we praise the Lord in this place where people have been coming together since 1869 at this very location to sing praises to the Lord. So welcome to you all. We have an announcement this morning. Paul, where are you?
Good morning. This coming Wednesday, March the 2nd, we're going to start a men's Bible study class. It's a carry-off of Authentic Manhood. The title of this session, it's a six-week session, is going to be A Man and His Work. Okay, I've already got several people signed up for this. If you want to see me after the service, I'll be out here and I'll be around for the potluck because I like to eat. But I can get your name on the list. I can get you a book before Wednesday if you can't make it to Wednesday. It's not a study that you have to come each and every Wednesday to get something out of it. But I believe that everybody will get something out of it. It's going to be starting May 2nd. It's going to run for 6 weeks. The start time is at 6:20. Anybody got anything else scheduled for 6:20? You might have 6 o'clock. You might have 6:30. But you don't have any 6:20. So, no excuses there. Pastor Troy said he was going to feed us if there wasn't too many. Why should we limit God? $15 for a book. See me out in the foyer or over at the Family Life Center. Thank you.
Okay, 6:20. You can't forget that time for sure. And Paul also mentioned the potluck. So stick around after this service. Everyone's welcome. Come to the potluck and continue to visit and share your memories of this place and spend time with old friends and new ones. Any other announcements this morning? Let us pray together. Most gracious Lord, we come here today from different backgrounds and different places on this homecoming Sunday, but we all came because you called us, Lord. You called us to come to this place. So here we are, such as we are. So we ask you now, Lord, to help us to be still and be quiet so that we can move away any distraction that would separate us from you and the message that you want us to hear today. Lord, we are here to learn your will. And we ask you now, we ask you for a miracle. We ask you to change each one of us into the people you created us to be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. We're singing out of the Heavenly Highway this morning, most of the songs. And if you'd like to have one, I think we have a few back here at the back. If you'd like to raise your hand and get one, if you can read music, I can't. I just blow and go, what I do. God give Danny a big old mouth, and I just try to let him have it, you know. Let's stand together and sing. On the Jericho Road. As we travel along, it's all of us, we're traveling along.
Yeah.
standing together as we unite in the Apostles' Creed, this historic confession of the Christian faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Ushers, you're invited to come forward now. Let's pray together. Most gracious Lord, we come here this morning with grateful hearts. We come here remembering the blessings that you have poured out into our lives and the lives of our families and those that we know. We praise you and we thank you now for the opportunity to give back to you a portion of what is already yours. And Lord, we pray that you will accept this offering of your people. You will join it with the offerings of other churches, other congregations, so that your word can be proclaimed throughout the earth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Singing in the heavenly highways, number 13 and 259 together. So be ready. We'll shake it up a little bit. I should not be moved. That's what I love him so.
Someone guides me. And he invited Philip to get in went and sat beside him. Now the passage of the scripture that he was reading was this: like a sheep he was led to the slaughter, and like a lamb silent before its shearer, so he does not open his mouth. In his humiliation, justice was denied him. Who can describe his generation? For his life is taken away from the earth. The eunuch asked Philip, about whom, may I ask you, does the prophet say this, about himself or someone else? Then Philip began to speak, and starting with this scripture, he proclaimed to him the good news about Jesus. As they were going along the road, they came to some water, and the eunuch said, look, here is water. What is to prevent me from being baptized? He commanded the chariot to stop, and both of them, Philip and the eunuch, went down into the water, and Philip baptized him. When they came up out of the water, the Spirit of the Lord snatched Philip away, and the eunuch saw him no more, and went on his way rejoicing. But Philip found himself at Azotus, and as he was passing through the region, he proclaimed the good news of all the towns, and he came to Caesarea. This is the good news. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Jessica, you waiting on us? All right, children, it's time for Children's Church. I know you want to stick around and sing some of the good old songs with us, but I bet Jessica's got a bunch of good old songs for you, too. Our next song this morning is I'll Fly Away. Richard Madison's going to be playing the piano for us, so hold on. And somebody man the fire extinguishers, because he can make it rock. Let's stand together and sing, I'll Fly Away. I hope when he comes to get me, we're singing his song. Churches were held in saloons and stuff back in the day, because that's the only place there was a piano. They didn't have church buildings like we have today. You know, they'd go to the saloon on Sunday and shut down the bar for just a little bit and sing, and that's where we learned playing like Richard plays. You know, I mean, it's amazing. If you ever ever get to go to Branson and you go to a place that has a lot of good entertainment on Saturday night, you probably go back on Sunday and get some good religion on Sunday morning, because they got some talented people in Branson. They can play that thing.
I learned these hymns, and they meant a lot to me. To hear my grandmother singing these hymns when she was cooking and making the biscuits and gravy that I love to have. And then when I went into the ministry, I saw the power of the words that are set to tunes. And it really has changed my outlook on the way that we look at music and the way that we look at the way that we do church. And I just want to tell you a story real quick about a lady. Her name was Helen Hill. And Helen, whenever I met her, she was 91 years old, and she was in the nursing home for about 6 years, and she had gotten Alzheimer's disease. And whenever you went to go and visit with Helen, she didn't know your name, she couldn't remember anything about you, but one thing that she could do is that she could sing the old hymns. She remembered every word to Amazing Grace, standing on the promises, I'll fly away. And that's what she would do. As soon as she saw you, she may not be able to communicate to you directly, but she communicated to you through her words and her song that she had. We all know people who are like that, that becomes an unconscious part of who we are, and it becomes the part of our DNA and our soul, these old songs. And this church was built upon those old songs. Whenever you read the story of how we first were a campground, and that's what we were, they sang these hymns, and these hymns were passed down from generation to generation, and they have power in their words, and they move us to our very soul. So now, telling you all of that, I have got a challenge for Danny and the choir and for Lisa. I would like for you guys to grab this Heavenly Highway book, if you got one, and pick out a song that you would like to hear today. Any song. I can tell you, I am going to pick out number 219, The Unclouded Day. That was my grandmother's favorite song, The Unclouded Day. Let's take three more. Hey, hang on. Let's start up here. 84. All right, number 84. Amen. All right. And so graduate. Number 12. What? 12? Okay. 166. Okay, 204. Let's do two more. Let's write down two more. Wait, I can't hear what you're saying. I'm sorry. 36. One more. 19.
Thank you, Padre.
You know what? Let me pray for you guys real quick. Our gracious Lord, how blessed we truly are to be able to come together and sing praises to your name, because your Son, Jesus Christ, has given us forgiveness and hope. And Lord, we sing today with joy and with love in our hearts. Bless the choir and Lisa and Danny and what they do and this congregation. Help us to be the hands and feet of Christ in this world for generations to come, helping people up, giving them a helping hand, and always with a song on our lips. In Jesus' name we pray.
Your hand. First thing we're gonna do. We're gonna do Church in the Wildwood. It's not in that book. There you go. That sister knows her music. It's out of the Cokesbury. That's before the Heavenly Highway. If you can remain seated, y'all can stand if you want to, or sit if you want to. I can't be still. It's Church in the Wildwood. It's in this book, and it's not on the screen or anything. It's 121, and it's the Cokesbury. We got one of those. This is a preacher's song. He said he wanted to sing, so we're going to sing it.
Verses 1 and 3. I thought through that.
Walk with Thee is 19 in the Heavenly Highway. Verses 1 and 3. And I think I know it too. Yeah. This was a demand, not a request. Just a little talk with Jesus. All right. Let's see who can sing and talk with Jesus. Stand together if you want to. Sit there if you want to. Run up down the aisles if you want to. We're going to sing all three verses of this baby. Who's got a, so I'm going to show you somebody that's thought of another one since then. That's all. sound like work to me?
Well, they didn't leave the ones they suggested.
No, but you're up here. us another number, David.
101.
Thank you.
first for the potluck and for the future of our church. Let's pray. Our gracious God, we are so truly blessed this day to be able to come together as a family of God, united in praise and thanksgiving of your holy name. Lord, please take our worship for what it is, straight from our hearts and straight from our souls. As we've heard the numbers of the hymns being called out today, it reminds me so much of how your love has touched all of us in one way or another, and how these songs have touched us all. And we pray, Lord, that in the future, that all of our children and grandchildren will come to know you through words and by deeds and also through music as well. We thank you, gracious Lord, for all the saints who have gone on before us, who have made this church into what it is today, from the initial campgrounds to the beautiful sanctuary that we have now. All the hard work and sweat and toil has paid off, because we are planting the seeds for a bright and wonderful future where there will never be a clouded day. We pray, Lord, all these things. I ask that you would bless our food and our fellowship here in just a little bit. And until then, Lord, we pray as you taught us to pray so long ago. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.